Happy morning, cuties. Today we have to cover unit 4 and day 13. All the time while you are attending the online class, make sure that you have student reader, workbook, pencil, eraser, crayons along with you. Shall we go to the class, Kutima? Yeah, great. Now you and all opened your SR book, SR 10. I will give you 5 seconds time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. I hope you and all opened your SR book. See here, Kutima, this is the SR 10 magic word. Okay, magic word E with vowels on O. Now we will read a story. See here. That magic word E with vowels on O, words having blue color, right? Now I will read the story. Listen carefully, okay? Rose, rose. The mole woke up. Mole woke up. Rose, the mole woke up. She looked outside the hole. She looked outside the hole. She looked outside the hole. Rose spotted a note. Rose spotted a note. The note said, come to the party. The note said, come to the party. Rose got on a bus. Rose got on a bus. She reached the party. She reached the party. She danced and sang it in happy tone. She danced and sang in the happy tone. Again, I read the story. Listen carefully, my dear kids. Rose, the mole woke up. She looked outside the hole. Rose spotted a note. The note said, come to the party. Rose caught on a bus. She reached the party. She danced and sang it in happy tone. Right? Now I'll say the magic word E with vowels and O words. Right? Rose. Rose. Can you repeat after me? Rose. Then mole. Mole. Can you repeat after me? Mole. Then woke. Woke. Again, hole. Hole. Repeat after me. Hole. Rose. Rose. Note. 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 Rose. Tone. Tone. So this is the magic word E with vowels on O, right? So again I will read the story. You also come along and read with me, okay? Rose the mole woke up. She looked outside the hole. Rose spotted a note. The note said, come to the party. Rose got on a bus. She reached the party. She danced and sang it in happy tone, right? So from your home you will read this magic word with vowels on O. Okay, great, Kutima. Now I will teach you a whole words, right? We will learn how to write the spellings of a new words, right? We have learned in this unit so far, right? Okay, already you did, right? Whole word section in your notebook. Now take your note that, okay? I will give you 5 seconds time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Now I will show you a flashcard. How to read that word, okay? See the flashcard, looking that, right? See here. I. D E A. I D E A. Can you repeat after me? I D E A. What is the whole word? Idea. Idea. Again I will say I D E ये आइडिया. सी द नेक्स्ट फॉर वर्ड एल ए यू जी एच. अगेन एल ए यू जी एच. रिपीट आफ्टर मी एल ए यू जी एच. व्हाट इज दैट होल वर्ड? कैन यू से द वर्ड? या लव. लव अगेन एल ए यू जी एच. लव. नेक्स्ट आई विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट होल वर्ड. सी हियर ए एन वाई टी एच आई एन जी. अगेन ए एन वाई टी एच आई एन जी. व्हाट इज दैट होल वर्ड? कैन यू से? या एनीथिंग. एनीथिंग. अगेन आई विल रीड दैट. ए एन वाई टी एच आई एन जी. एनीथिंग. एनीथिंग. नेक्स्ट आई विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट होल वर्ड. डिमा एफ आर ओ एन टी. फ्रेंड. एफ आर ओ एन टी. फ्रेंड. अगेन रिपीट आफ्टर मी एफ आर ओ एन टी. फ्रेंड. नेक्स्ट होल वर्ड डब्ल्यू ओ आर एल बी. डब्ल्यू ओ आर एल बी. वर्ल्ड. वर्ल्ड. डब्ल्यू ओ आर एल डी. वर्ल्ड. वर्ल्ड. डी आई एफ एफ आई सी यू एल टी. डिफिकल्ट. डिफिकल्ट. डी आई एफ एफ आई सी यू एल टी. डिफिकल्ट. व्हाट इज दैट होल वर्ड? डिफिकल्ट. बी ई एंड डी. अगेन बी ई एंड डी. बेंड. बेंड. रिपीट आफ्टर मी बी ई एंड डी. बेंड. बेंड. अगेन आई विल शो यू दैट फ्लैश कार्ड्स. नाउ यू विल टेक योर नोटबुक. यू विल राइट दिस होल वर्ड्स. ओके. सी हियर आइडिया. आइडिया. लव. लव. एनीथिंग. एनीथिंग. See here, friend, friend. World, world. Difficult, difficult, difficult. Bend, bend. So from your notebook, you have to write this whole words, okay? Spell and write it, okay? For this whole words, okay, Kutima? Yeah, great. Now, I will teach you a reading and listening comprehension, right? In yesterday's class, I gave one homework, right? Now, shall we discuss that worksheet? Worksheet 22 and 23. Question number 2, then 23, question number 1. Take your worksheet. I will give you 5 seconds time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. I hope you and all opened your worksheet, right? See here, this is the read the story on SR 14 and answer the following questions. Did you complete, Kutima? Which hand does Naina use to do everything, right? Then B question, what makes Naina sad? Then why does Naina get upset while writing? Did you complete that? Now I will show you your answer, right? See here. Which hand does Naina use to everything, right? Naina uses her left hand to do everything, right? Then what makes Naina sad? Naina gets sad that right-handed friends can do things easily while she struggles, right? Then third one. Why does Naina get upset while writing? Naina gets upset while writing because her left hand keeps rubbing the letters, right? Did you complete this page, my dear kids? See here. If you are not, means take that and complete, okay? See here, worksheet 23, D question. my friends can do things easily while I struggle. What do you think is meaning of this underlined word? Do you know that? Then E question. Have you had to do something that has difficult for you? How did you do it, right? Now I will show you the answer. Just you have to verify, okay? See here, my dear children. What is that? Struggle means find something difficult, right? Then E question. Yes, I had to do something difficult, right? Yeah. That E question, your wish, my dear kids, okay? Now again see that story, okay? What are the parts that every story has? How do we find the main problem and solution in a story, okay? Now see here, I'll read again the story, okay? Who is Lefty? Who is the author? Namita Gold, right? Illustrator Kiddy Benhar. See the first page. In the world of right-handed people, Naina is a lefty. She is a left hand, right? She uses left hand for everything. She eats with her left hand, right? Then second page. She writes with her left hand. She even cuts paper using her left hand. See here. She even cuts paper using her left hand, right? Some of the things are difficult to do. Some of the things are difficult to do, right? See the next page. While writing, Naina left hand keeps rubbing the letters, right? She asked her teacher what to do. Her teacher told her that she will think of something, right? Shall we move to the next page? See the next page. Next day, the teacher got her a ink that dries fast. Naina could now write without rubbing the letters, right? Turn the next page, my dear kids. Today, for homework, she has to cut shapes. Naina tried to cut the paper with scissors. Every time, the paper would bend. She started crying and went to her mother. Shall we move to the next page? Yeah. Her mother asked, "What happened?" Naina said, "It is difficult to cut things with my left hand. My friends can do things easily while I struggle." See the next page. Mother saw the scissors and knew the problem. "I am going to the market. I will be back in some time," said mother, right? Next page. Naina waited for her mother to come back. After some time, her mother came home. She had a packet of left-handed scissors. She gave it to Naina. So from this story, shall we discuss some questions, my dear kids? See here. Settings. Where is the story taking place? See here. In Naina's home, right? Characters. Who are the characters in the story? Naina, then her mother. Right. Naina and her mother. Right? See here. Naina and her mother. Right? And teacher also, right? Then problem. What was the problem faced by the characters? See here. See this. She has to cut shapes, right? It is very difficult to her because she used left hand, right? Then next, resolve the problem. What did the character do to resolve the problem? Do you know that? Yeah. Her mom gave a left hand scissor. She bought a left hand scissor and gave to Naina, right? And what was the solution to this problem? She used left hand scissors and it was very easy to her, right? Cut the shapes. Do you understand? So this slide, we have to think about the story, okay? So my dear kids, while reading a story, we can also make a connection and think about how we are similar to the character in the story, right? We can ask ourselves if a similar things has happened to us and what did we do, right? Now you will open your SR book, SR 17. Okay, I will give you 5 seconds time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. I hope you and all opened your SR 17. You will read that story, okay? You have to read this story, Kutima. First of all, I will read on time. In your home, you will read this, okay? See here. My tooth. Author, Namita Girl. Illustrator, Hirdi Benha. See here, I got up this morning. As a routine, I went to brush my teeth. I felt pain while brushing. I saw one of my teeth is loose. See here. See the picture and then connect this. Right? While you are reading, what I said already, you will connect that story, right? 5 questions you have to ask, think yourself, right? Second, I started wondering when will I lose my tooth? Will I lose it while eating breakfast? Next page. Maybe I will lose it in school. Maybe I will lose it in the school bus. Hopefully, my friends will help me, right? See the next page. Maybe I will lose it while playing. Maybe I will lose it while sleeping. Oh no, it will be so painful. I slept thinking about my tooth. See here. Then, when I woke up, I felt something in my mouth. It was my tooth. It didn't cause any pain. I was worrying too much for nothing. So from this story, you have to think about that settings, characters, what was the problem, then resolve the problem, then last one, right? You have to read yourself, then think that like questions, right? So from your home, you will read that story and think about that stories, right? Now, I will teach you a grammar, right? Making a sentence with adverbs. My dear kids, in the last few classes, we have seen sentences and identified adverbs in them, right? Today, we will write our own sentences using adverbs, right? Do you know what is adverb? Adverbs describe the actions, right? Shall you say some examples? Shall I say it now? Yeah, slowly, eat slowly, talk loudly, jump high. So from that, slowly, loudly, high, they are all the adverbs, right? Now, I will show you one slide, right? See here, Kutima, adverbs are words that describe an action, right? Adverbs are words that describe an action. The boy is doing an action in this picture. See here. You will say the answer. What action is he doing? What action? First question. What action is he doing? Yeah, very good. Running. What is that? Running. Then second question. How he is running? If anybody say, how he is running, my dear kid? How? See their face, emotions. What is that? Happily. Yeah, great, my dear kid. Happily. How he is running? Happily, right? See here. What action is he doing? Running. What is that? Running. How he is running? Happily. How he is running? Happily. So, adverbs are words that describe an action. The boy is doing an action in this picture. See here. He is running. How he is running? He is running happily, right? Do you understand the adverb, my dear kid? Yeah, great. Now, I will teach you a writing and speaking expression. So, you will improve your speaking skill. That is more important, my dear kid, right? Do you remember that at the end of the last unit, we had a set goals for ourselves? Yes, right? What is the goal? Do you know that? What is the goal, my dear kid? A goal is a desired result or aim. Do you have any goal? Yeah, I have a goal. A goal is a desired result or aim. My aim is become a something like that. You have to say this like, my aim is become a teacher or a principal like that, okay? So, dear students, you have to follow these two steps to achieve a goal. First of all, the first one is set a goal. First, you have to set your goal, what you have to think, right? After that, take actions to achieve your goal. What we do next, okay? First one, set your goal. The second one, take actions to achieve your goal, okay? So, today, all of you are going to share what actions you have taken to achieve your goal with the whole class, right? Today we will discuss our goal. Now I will say some example, right? Listen carefully, okay, Makutis? My goal was to become a good badminton. My goal was to become a badminton. I wanted to learn how to play it and become a good at it. First, we set a goal, right? What is that? Badminton. If you are a badminton, means what you do first? You need to follow or see that how to play it and become a good at it, right? So, I had set a goal for myself. I decided a goal for myself, right? I decided that for the next 1 month, I will understand the rules to play badminton, right? Then, I'll say again, I decided that for the next 1 month, I will understand the rules to play badminton. First of all, we will understand the rules to play the badminton. We know that, right? What are the rules they are following to the badminton? And practice playing with my friends every day. Daily you have to practice that badminton, right? That is easy to achieve your goal, right? Again, I will read that. I decided that for the next 1 month, I will understand the rules to play badminton and practice playing it with my friends every day. Okay? The action steps I wanted to take to achieve this goal were: learn the rules to play badminton. What is that first? Learn the rules to play badminton. Second one, practice playing it with my friends every day in the evening. It has been 2 weeks since I set this goal for myself. So far, I have been playing every day in the evening with my friend. I also remember almost the rules. Sometimes when I forgot a rule, my friend reminds me. I am getting good at it. So, just you have to aim or think your goal. After that, you have to achieve your goal, my dear kid, okay? First, you have to set a goal. After that, take actions to achieve your goal, right? So, my dear kids, this slide in your home, you have to think. Set your goal first. After that, take actions to achieve your goal. From next class, I will ask this like questions, okay? Then narrate your goals, okay? First of all, think your goal. You must set a goal. After that, take actions to achieve your goal. Give one examples from tomorrow class, okay? Now, shall we recall today's class, my dear kids? Yeah, phonics. We read the magic word E with vowel sound O, one story, right? Then, whole words. We read the whole words. Then, write the whole words from your notebook, right? Then, reading and listening comprehension. We discussed that worksheet. After that, your independent reading, one story, right? In grammar part, make a sentences with adverbs. Do you understand that adverbs? Yeah. We saw one slide, right? We know about the adverbs. What is that adverbs? Adverbs describe the actions, right? After that, writing and speaking expression. What are the two steps of achieve a goal, right? First one, set a goal, then take actions to achieve your goal, right? Now, I will give homework, right? Grammar part. Ask students, dear students, to observe your parents and your family members at home, okay? Today, right? And then write 5 sentences about your actions using adverbs in your notebooks, okay? Again, I will recall, you observe your parents and your family members at home today, my dear kids. After that, write 5 sentences about your actions using adverbs in your notebooks, okay? Okay, goodies. Bye. Happy learning. Thank you.